My name is Léonard Bezinge, and in this video, I will spotlight our research recently published in the journal Allergy. The basophil activation test is an in vitro functional assay for allergy diagnosis that measures how basophils react, whether they activate or not, when exposed to an allergen or control. As the use of this test becomes more widespread and efforts for standardization increase, we notice that a critical point remains neglected. How does the number of basophils impact test results? In this animation, you can see an example of how the measured activation varies as more and more basophils are recorded. These variations may ultimately affect the outcome of the test. If we can take a decision using fewer basophils, this can speed up data acquisition and reduce the volume of blood required. In our letter, we demonstrate how to handle low basophil counts while still maintaining high confidence in the test results. To understand these variations, we analyzed a large data set of over 1,000 basophil activation tests. This allowed us to quantify this variation and develop the statistical model to describe them. Here is why this matters. Let's consider false positive rates, for example. When negative samples are measured, many of these could be incorrectly classified as positive at low basophil counts if we used a fixed cutoff. If we now account for the variability that comes from having a limited number of basophils, we can integrate this aspect in our cutoff and keep false positive at a minimum, even with few basophils. So how can you apply this method when analyzing your basophil activation tests? Instead of relying on a fixed cutoff to determine positive versus negative results, we suggest using a confidence margin around this cutoff within which results are considered inconclusive. Here are, for instance, rule of thumb values to quickly assess this margin for different basophil counts. Do you want to learn more about our research? Click the link in the description and check the latest issue of Allergy.